This is our eighth annual banquet. Our eighth annual banquet, yep. So through the only through the grace of God have we made it through 8 years. We certainly know that. And in a special way today, I'd like to show you this beautiful picture that we have in our ultrasound room. And this is an image of God the Father. So you may not be able to see it from the distance that you're at, but it's a beautiful image of God the Father. And he is putting his arms out to embrace this beautiful little unborn child. And to me, this is typifies exactly what St. Gerard's is about. St. Gerard's is about uniting our work, our mission with Christ, the Heavenly Father, and the Holy Spirit to not just save lives, but also to save souls. It's a twofold mission. And I was contemplating a lot about God the Father and his role, of course, in protecting the unborn. And I want to read to you this brief excerpt that was written by Dr. Merivale. And he is a theology professor at Franciscan University in Steubenville, Ohio. And I think what he has to say is very, very beautiful. So I'm going to read it. He states, "We must continue to wage the battle for the unborn child today with unmitigated fervor, compromised neither by the length of time we have been at battle, which has now been over 30 years for Roe versus Wade, nor by our own human progress, a potential future, political success or failure. As long as there is a single unborn child at risk, we have our mission, regardless of the dubious agendas or the inconsistencies of US judges, court rulings, and legislation. We must adopt the mind and the heart of the Savior, who accepts the mission to save souls, one person at a time, out of obedience to the Heavenly Father, and in the virtue of the unquestioned necessity of human redemption. Abba Father's desire for each one of us is to pray and work to protect his unborn image, and the necessity to do so in our tragic times of the culture of death is simply beyond question." Beautiful, beautiful words, and I think it's very exactly what we're about at St. Gerard's. And all I can say is the grace and the blessings of what we received in terms of helping these mothers is truly been through the fruits of prayer. Currently, right now, we have served more than 3,800 mother and children in need and throughout the past 8 years, which is, again, phenomenal, phenomenal numbers. And also, through the grace of God, more than 400 babies were saved, which, again, otherwise would have died from abortion. Again, we take no credit for that. That is the power of Jesus and the Blessed Mother working in the hearts of those mothers to do God's will and have their babies. And we know that it's truly through the power of prayer that the babies are being saved. We pray, of course, as you know, in front of the abortion clinic. We pray at St. Gerard's. Many of us are very devout. I see people at adoration. We're always praying. And it's really through the prayer only. As Monsignor Riley, who's going to speak in a few minutes, as he would say, that it's 99% prayer and 1% of our efforts. So we know that without a doubt. And just to give you a wonderful example of that, is this past Saturday, we had the Helpers of God's Precious Infants. We were all out there. We prayed the rosary, all the mysteries of the rosary. We prayed the chaplet. And really, we didn't actually see women going in, not too many, just a very few, and some were coming out who tragically had abortions. And so we went back to the church and prayed. And then when I got to St. Gerard's, one of our moms, she's not with us today, but she said, "Teresa, I need to speak to you." She said, "I brought a girl here who is considering abortion. Will you please talk to her?" I said, "Absolutely." So when I went upstairs, this young lady told me that this mom in our program, I'll just give a fictitious name, her name is Mary, that's not her name, but close. But anyway, she said that Mary just literally dragged her to St. Gerard's. And she was, you know, during the time that we were out there praying in front of the abortion clinic was the time that she was talking to Mary about coming to St. Gerard's to choose life. So to me, that is an illustration of the power of prayer. That it was nothing that we did, we just simply prayed. And God, of course, was working to save that precious baby's life. And I'm excited to tell you that she did choose life. Praise the Lord. So we're coming for an ultrasound. And also at the previous vigil, at the previous helpers vigils, again, we were out there in intense prayer. And I spoke to one lady. I thought she was going to do God's will and have her baby, but unfortunately she went back in because she was greatly pressured by her boyfriend. And so later in the week, I received a phone call from a woman from the Hispanic Health Council, and she was telling me that there's a woman that was considering abortion and she needs your help. And so when I met this young lady, she said that she was there on that Saturday, not this past month, but the previous month. And she said when she saw everyone out there praying, she said she realized what she was about to do was very, very wrong. And so she asked her friend to turn the car around and not get out and leave. And so she left. And this is also a mother who came to us for an ultrasound. And to just see the immense joy in this girl when she saw her precious baby after she received the ultrasound, it's just a great, great gift. It's been awesome being able to do that. We have been doing the ultrasound services now for up 1 year, just a little over a year. We started April the 26th of 2011, so we've just been like literally 1 year old. And all I can tell you is that it's been a phenomenal, phenomenal experience. Anita Morrison, she is one of the ladies that is serving there at helping with ultrasounds. Yay, Anita. The important thing that you need to know about St. Gerard's is that how the power of how God is using everyone. It's not me, it's every person at St. Gerard's is being used in a powerful way through the grace of God to save lives. And Anita is a phenomenal advisor and mentor. She's just great with these girls. But what I was saying about our ultrasound services is, as I said, we've been running for over a year now. And through the grace of God, we have done well over 150 scans. We have had 60 patients, 60 women have come to us as patients. And again, through the grace of God, not our efforts, 31 babies have been saved, which otherwise would have died from abortion. It's really through a power of God's grace. And it's also how, as I said, God's using people at St. Gerard's to help save lives. I'm gonna talk about a few people. Actually, Mary Pizzantini, who's here, she's one of our volunteers. Mary is a phenomenal volunteer, and she's very faithful. And Mary has been there at St. Gerard's at critical times when we receive phone calls. And one phone call in particularly, was a young lady who said that she wants to have an abortion. She thought we were an abortion clinic, actually. And so Mary said, oh, well, the person you need to speak to isn't here, but I'm gonna I need your number so that she can call you. And so Mary called me immediately. And this woman said, well, I need to have an abortion, and my husband's not working. We don't have any resources. We just simply can't have this child. And I kept talking to her, and she goes, well, when can I schedule the abortion? And I said, well, you know, we'd like to have you come for an ultrasound. We want to help you to have the baby. And she goes, well, I'm not interested in that. And so she hung up the phone. And as I said, we definitely pray with great fervor. And so the following week, I just received an inspiration to call that woman. And I do the scheduling for the ultrasounds on a Monday, and the girls come on Tuesdays. That's when we do the ultrasounds. And when I called this, I decided to call that woman who hung up on me. And she said, it's so funny that you called me, because she said, my husband and I were thinking about it, and we decided to have the baby. And we were just thinking about you this morning, and thinking about how we could get in contact with you. So again, through the grace of God, another amazing miracle. And we have a new volunteer coordinator. Her name is Karen Germain. I don't know where you are. She's in line getting food. But Karen is also a wonderful, wonderful blessing to us in coordinating the volunteers and helping us get our database up and going. And Karen has also been very helpful in interceding some of the calls. And one call in particular was from a mom who said that she was in front of St. Gerard's on Maple Avenue and nobody was there. And she's definitely got a plan to have an abortion unless somebody talks to her. So of course, Karen called me right away. And I'd like to introduce you to this mom. This is Samantha. Come on over. And Samantha came to me and told me that she had no place to live, and that because she was totally homeless, that she wouldn't be able to care for her child. And I told her we would help her to get a place to live, and that we truly cared and we wanted her to have this precious baby, and that we would give her all the support that she needed. And so we found a location in East Hartford, a boarding house for Samantha. She's going to live there for a temporary time, and this helped her with getting established and knowing that we're there for her to have this precious baby. And she also came for an ultrasound this week. And it was so beautiful, the words that she said after seeing her baby. And one of the questions is, what did you like best or least about the medical services you received? And she said, I saw the baby's heart beating. Such a joy. And then the other question is, did the ultrasound provide you or influence your decision in regarding your pregnancy? And she said, I will never regret deciding to have my child. Seeing the heart beating gave me such joy, and I can't wait to have my little one in my arms. That's so awesome. So let's give it. Would you like to say anything? Would you like to say anything? It's okay.
She's good at that. Hi, everyone.
Hey, Samantha.
Yeah, that's just a little of my story. Thanks to St. Gerard's, I decided to have my baby, and I'm very grateful and thankful, and I just can't wait to have my baby. Each and every day I say the same thing. I just can't wait to have it. And I thank you guys so much, because if it wasn't for you, I would have lived the worst thing ever. So thank you.
We love you. We also had another amazing story that happened. Again, this is a total grace from God. Last May, when we again just began the ultrasound services, I was there one day in front of the abortion clinic, and I saw this young couple go in, and I tried to reach to them, but they of course ignored me. And then I was just about getting ready to leave, and I saw that same couple come out. And so I went over to talk to them, and I asked the young lady how far along she was, and she just kind of smiled but wouldn't tell me. And then I started to tell them about coming to St. Gerard's for an ultrasound. And I started to show them the baby in the womb. And I told them that the baby's heart was beating at 24 days, and that the baby had brain waves at 43 days, and that the baby's stomach, liver, and lungs were totally intact by 6 to 7 weeks, this perfect little precious baby. So they listened with me and they said, well, we'll think about it. Well, they came that day on May 31st. And everybody, you know what day May 31st is? That's the Feast of the Visitation. The Feast of the Visitation. So they came that day, and she came for the ultrasound, and literally, when she went to the scan, the baby was leaping and jumping in the womb. And it's very symbolic that, of course, on this day, the Feast of the Visitation, that this baby would be leaping and waving and jumping in the womb. And I remember her boyfriend went in to see the baby, and he came out and he said, that baby's breakdancing in there. So it was a beautiful moment. She later texted me and said that they wanted to get married, and I know that she's having a precious baby girl, or had a precious baby girl. Yes.
Samantha's due date is Christmas Day.
Oh yes, and Anita just reminded me to tell you all that Samantha's due date is on Christmas Day. Christmas Day. Yes, okay. And I have one other story before I introduce the other girls. Veronica, can you bring that precious baby up here? Veronica.
Thanks.
So you have to always watch what you pray for. And my birthday is on November the 26th. And so this past November, what I did was I said to Jesus, I said, I don't want any gifts. I don't want a dinner. I don't want a party. I don't want anything. I just want a baby safe from abortion. So I said, I just want a baby saved from abortion. And so on Friday, I was out there sidewalk counseling, and there was no women changing their mind. And then Saturday came, it was my birthday, no ladies changed their mind. And then so I was, but then on my birthday, of course, people took me out to dinner, I got 2 birthday cakes, and I was saying to Jesus, I just said I didn't want any of those things. I didn't want that, I just wanted a baby. And so what happens is Sunday, I'm leaving a bottle drive, and I'm in this parking lot at a grocery store, and I get a call from Veronica, which is the grandmother of this baby, and she said, Teresa, she said, Christy, who's the mother of the child here, she said, Christy had her baby, and I said, oh. And she said, I said, what day? And she said, yesterday. So this is Christy, the mother of this baby, and Christy chose life, and this is my birthday present. And it's the best birthday present I ever received. And Christy, would you like to say something?
I just want to say thank you to Teresa and St. Gerard's for all their help. Before I was pregnant, I had a really bad drug and alcohol problem. And unexpectedly, I became pregnant. And I asked my mother for help, and she told me to give Teresa a call to talk to you about keeping Tyler because I wasn't going to keep him. It was just going down the wrong road, and I decided to keep him, and he's changed me so much. I'm over a year clean now.
Yay!
And I just want to say thank you to her and my mother and just everyone's help with helping me to keep Tyler and just
bless
everyone.
We love you. We love you.
And by the way, he's a Polish baby. Yay!
That was a direct order.
Oh, he's Italian too? Oh, so.
Okay, I gotta give credit to the Italian. I'm sorry. Okay. I also wanted to bring up some other mothers that have chosen life, and I've got Wendy, and also just Mary. And these are ladies that actually were at the last banquet, but now they have their babies. So I wanted to introduce to you Wendy and our little baby Ileana. Yay! And also this is just Mary and our little daddy Air. Yay! And I don't know if you remember that story about Wendy, me meeting her mother at the bank and giving the card, and then of course that's how we got connected, and because of course she was considering abortion, and of course now she has this precious little baby Ileana. And I have to tell you, I'm very proud of Wendy, because Wendy was just telling me on the way down here that she is working full time. She works from Sunday through Thursday. She goes to work at 8 o'clock at night, works all night long, every one of those days. Her mother is watching her baby while she works, and so that means she gets absolutely no sleep. During the week, she is actually taking care of things for the baby, so she hardly has time to rest. But I just have to give her great, great credit for what an awesome job she's doing. And now we have also Dismary and her precious baby daddy Air. And if you remember from about this Mary situation, was she had lupus. And that's very serious condition, which they told her to abort daddy Air. And of course, through, because this Mary has great faith in Jesus, and know that God would get her through that, knowing that she'd have the precious baby and still be okay. She chose life, and here we have this precious little boy now. Praise the Lord. Okay, thank you girls so much. This is just another one of our mothers. This is Lisa, and Lisa always wanted to have her baby, so she was very excited about that, but she just came to have an ultrasound on Tuesday, and your baby is what, 18 weeks in the womb? Mm-hmm. Would you like to say something about that? Or, yeah.
I don't really know what to say, but at first I was gonna choose abortion because it's my third child. And I didn't really know what to do, and me and my husband were struggling, but St. Gerard really helped me out, and you know, I'm stable now, and I'm 5 months pregnant, and I chose life,
All right.
Lisa is also married, and this is her little girl. What's your little girl's name?
Selena.
What is it?
Selena.
Selena. Okay, so thank you. Thank you so much.
God bless you.
Did I miss any other mothers? I don't know if I missed anybody else, but we have other mothers from St. Gerard's. Would you like to stand up? Anybody like to stand up? Oh, okay. I also wanted to say that our program has expanded. We are now also, in addition to doing the ultrasound services, we are at 59 Eaton Street in Hartford, and we've been there for actually over a year now, too, as well. And the program is going so, so well. And one person I'd like to also highlight today is Mary Ives. And Mary Ives coordinates our chastity program. And I'd like to share a story about one of the girls who talked to me about Mary, and she probably doesn't know about this, but I'm gonna say it. As one young lady told me that she had separated from her boyfriend, but of course he was still coming in around because of seeing the children. And one time he came and he was trying to pressure her to have an intimate relationship with him. And she said no. She said, no, this is wrong. It's wrong to do this and not be married. And if you want to do this with me, you're going to have to marry me. And she told me that this was because, you know, all the things that she learned from Mary's class, and that she feels so good about herself because she was able to be in that situation and have the strength and the courage to say no and do God's will. So she unfortunately is not here today, but I just wanted to give Mary that credit. We also have another woman who's teaching in the chastity program on Tuesdays. Her name is Lori Schwartz. She's doing a phenomenal, phenomenal job. We're trying to give the girls an option of what day they can come. And again, I'm hearing tons of positive feedback from the girls going to that class as well. So it's a message that we're teaching because we know that the girls can live that message if given the chance to be mentored. And also in a special way, I want to thank Brian Hartley, who's here. He's also been helping our girls coordinating the baptism program. Just give Brian a hand. Yep. And now we have more than 50 children baptized as Catholics, which is again a true, true gift from God. And also the Lord has blessed us with a deacon. We now have a deacon, Deacon Joseph Kane. He's also a part of our program. And actually through his efforts and seeing the girls during the week, we've had more like four or five children baptized. We just recently had a mother who had three children come into the church. So it's such a gift to be able to be doing this because we know that if the girls have Jesus Christ in their heart, even if they leave St. Gerard's, they will never consider abortion. They will never do that because they'll have the love of God in them. And that's one of our goals of St. Gerard's, is to make abortion unthinkable. And also, of course, to give that message of chastity. We also have another person here that does a great job, and that's Barbara Soloway. And Barbara helps the mothers who have gone through the pain and suffering of abortion. And she's an excellent mentor, and she has done a great job of reaching out to those girls, calling them, meeting with them. And so this is such an important part of our work. And literally, we have had girls who have had abortions, and they have come and brought the moms to us who were considering abortion. They were the spokesperson to stop that girl. I had one who recently told me that after she had her abortion, she was in such depression. And so when her friend was telling her she was going to consider abortion, she brought her right to St. Gerard's. And she said to me, Teresa, I would do anything to stop someone from doing that. She said, no matter what I would have to do to stop someone from going through that pain, I will do it. And to me, that's all a part of the healing. It's all a part of what, again, what God is doing in this program, is healing the girls and then bringing on those who are considering abortion to help them to choose life. It's really all the way in which God is using all of us. And I also want to give a special thanks today to Bob Dean. Bob Dean prays faithfully. Yes, let's give him a round of applause, please. He prays faithfully in front of the abortion clinic as Don Wheatley as well. And both of these men are just phenomenal. They're there all the time praying, reaching out to the girls. And Bob also takes on quite a responsibility for the center. He helps and manages all the finances. In addition to praying in front of the abortion facility, he's there coordinating, managing all the finances. getting your donations or letters out to you, those who are donating to us. And he's just an amazing, great friend and gift to me, and I just couldn't do it without him. So many blessings to you, Bob. And I also have to mention Christina Berger, also, and Seal Donahue. They prepared all this dinner, this entire event, and they worked very, very hard, and I just cannot thank God enough for them. Yes. Christina also does a great job of answering the phone, all of our messages, she answers them and gets back. So often we do have girls that are called that are abortion-minded, and Christina lets me know right away. And then I'm able to respond and call them back. And literally, because of her intervention, I am confident, I can confidently tell you that babies' lives have been saved. Because she was able to get on that phone, get that message, and get to me. And everybody knows that I'm hard to reach, right? That's a joke. And also, I would like to speak to you about one of our board members, Nick Ciccoli. He recently became on our board. And Nick is doing something very unique with the center. He is a very successful businessman himself. And he was really making a beautiful contribution to us because of his talent in managing businesses, owning his own business. And what we wanted to do was we wanted to reach out to businesses who are promoting the message of life, endorsing life. We have Hillside Automotive. They're on our website. They're awesome people in promoting life, and they have a business in Hartford. So they're one of the businesses listed, and we have several others. But he is literally on the phone, cold calling these businesses, trying to get them to support us. And it's not an easy job, because many times he gets lots of rejection, but he's still doing that and still reaching out, and he's definitely made a significant contribution. So I'd like everyone to give a round of applause to Nick. Thank you, Nick. There are so many other volunteers, and they're such a blessing, so if I'm missing anybody, please forgive me, but all of you matter greatly. Without your help and your support and your love and your prayers, we definitely could not do the ministry of St. Gerard's. So, and all those of you who are supporting our work, I just want to thank you with all my heart, because of your support, you're really making a difference in saving babies' lives and souls. God bless you.